You don't have to be an economist to understand that a skilled workforce is a necessity in a tech-driven economy. Training, and perhaps just as important, retraining, the workforce is likely to become a recurring challenge, sometimes an emergency. A McKinsey report forecasts 39 million to 73 million U.S. jobs could be destroyed by automation by 2030. Although about 20 million of those workers are expected to easily shift to similar occupations, that leaves millions who still need to make a living, but they need to be retrained. You can't just hop on a mechanized conveyor belt, start pushing buttons, and you certainly can't fix it without first understanding how its computers and its parts interact. That's where the challenge comes in. Politicians and business leaders typically turn to large-scale federal job training programs, but critics say they are clunky. They lack specificity for individual communities. As we hurtle toward automation saturation, the approach is starting to change, though. The federal government is now stressing demand-driven training that's coordinated with local industry. The goal? Make sure workers aren't retrained with new skills that turn out to be obsolete. Instead, look for gaps. Focus on those and make workers quickly hireable. A program at Great Bay Community College in Rochester, New Hampshire, great example. With money from a Labor Department grant, local companies teamed up with a nearby college to create the curriculum for a six-month certificate program.
Anybody who's not sure of their job skills and looking for work, I highly recommend looking into this.
Graduates walk out with new skills, and they can expect to start at $16 an hour working in composite manufacturing in their hometown, no less. A similar program is being launched in Connecticut. Gateway Community College and the New Haven-based Workforce Alliance created a five-week training course aligned with skills needed at local manufacturers. The Skill Up for Manufacturing program is funded with federal and state money, and it works with the unemployed plus underemployed. This all might sound kind of similar to training programs in other countries, like Denmark, which brings together employers, governments, and unions to make sure training's focused on the right set of skills. And what's more, private industry sponsors much of this training in Europe, investing in their own future workers. Of course, despite great effort, some older workers can still struggle in some of these training programs, meaning that they always have to be fine-tuned. This much is obvious. The driving force in training and retraining is now speed. Jobs spring up and fade away much faster in the tech age. Entire companies can have shorter lifespans, meaning many of us could be retrained for a new position several times in the span of our careers.